is Black Radio.
Welcome back to the Smorg Show Lounge. This is Chris, your host, on episode 131, recorded on December 31st, 2021. And I was not expecting to do this show. I thought we were done for the year. Oh my goodness. Oh, are you guys okay?
Hey, how's it going?
Hi.
Hey, it is my daughter, Allie, and my son-in-law, Thomas.
That is going to leave a mark.
Yeah, you okay, Thomas? I'm sorry, I didn't leave the lights on. Allie knows her way around here, but it's...
Ooh, I'll walk it off.
Yeah. Well, welcome, guys, to the SmorgShow Lounge.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Yeah. Happy New Year. Yeah, it's been a wild year.
It has been. And like I said, I wasn't planning on doing another episode this year. I thought we were kind of done because I put out that It's a Wonderful Life play. And I thought, I'm just going to phone it in for the rest of the year with that and then come back in the new year. But something told me you guys are over here for a late Christmas because you guys were down by Thomas's parents for Christmas this year. And you came over here later in the week. So since you're both here, this might be a good time to just kind of catch up.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
Just talk about the year. And actually, let me get right into that. I thought maybe we could do like, there we go. Nice.
Set the mood a little.
Yeah, let's kick back a little bit. I'm going to put on some ambiance for New Year's Eve.
Very nice.
And Allie and Thomas got me a mini fridge for the man cave.
That's right.
Jerry's going to love that when he comes back out here next month. But
because we felt like you didn't have enough things plugged in already, taking up all the outlets.
Yeah, well, you remember the story from a few years ago when we brought the Keurig coffee maker down here because Dave likes his coffee. And as soon as we're recording and all of a sudden I hit the brew and the power for the whole basement, the whole man cave just shuts down.
That was what pushed it over, I guess.
Yeah, not the 30 pieces of equipment. It was the coffee maker. So I thought, well, I'm not sure how this refrigerator is going to work, but it's holding up soon. So, I mean, holding up pretty well.
Doesn't need as much power to, I don't know, I guess, you know, brewing the cup of coffee uses a lot of wattage, where this, it's just a steady, I don't know, it's always on. You don't have to summon all of this energy to brew a cup of coffee.
Yeah. So, I mean, would you like me to pop a cold one open for any of you?
I'd love one. Yeah. Let's knock them back.
Cheers, everybody.
You too, Allie, or no?
What you got?
I got the toasted Bach. I've got some peanut butter whiskey in there, too.
Hey, but, I mean, just pour a glass.
Want one of these?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Nice.
Thank you. Look at that.
For those at home.
Now you don't have to run upstairs and grab something from the fridge all the way upstairs.
Yeah, this is dangerous because then...
Cheers.
Cheers.
There's no tabs being taken on how much I'm drinking either from the wife.
There's no witnesses, right. Yeah.
So for those of you at home, hopefully you're getting your brew while we still get situated here. Oh, nice.
Dissatisfying magnetic...
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy New Year. Let's hope 2022 goes a little better. Although this hasn't been a particularly bad year. You guys got married.
That's right.
A lot of stuff happened this year.
That's, sure did.
That's for sure. Yeah. I have been seeing things, though, about, you know, the joke that 2022 sounds like 2020.
Two.
Like T-O-O.
T-O-O, yeah.
Like a continuation of 2020. But
yeah.
But yeah, no, this was, I have no complaints about.
Definitely. No,
I choose to look at the highlights that happened.
Yeah. Yeah. There were a lot of big events, changes, I guess things that we didn't expect to happen and some things that we did expect to happen.
Yeah.
And a lot of, I would say, a lot of changes in the rest of the world, too. You know, who could have predicted what this this year would bring for all of us?
Right, for sure.
You know, I'm going to give that same advice that I gave everybody last year. Somebody had passed this on to me, and it worked pretty well. When everybody was complaining about 2020, how awful of a year it was, somebody had suggested if you take a lot of pictures, you know, with your iPhone or whatever, to just scroll through your pictures that you took through the year, and you will bound to you're bound to find something that it's like, hey, I forgot we did that this year. It was we made a pretty good year out of it.
Well, especially because January of this year seems so far away.
Oh my goodness.
You know, when you think about stuff that happened at the beginning of the year, it's like, oh my gosh, that was this year. It's like we had 5 years of history and packed into 1 year.
It really feels like it. Yes.
Well, you guys got really lucky there with, we had a break there before things started to get crazy again here in the great state of Illinois, with, you know, the COVID restrictions. So you guys had the wedding right at the end of summer.
Yeah.
And I mean, it was almost like pre-nuttiness.
Well, and it was outdoors, and we were planning on an outdoor wedding to begin with before all of, you know, COVID stuff. And it was like the most perfect, gorgeous day. I mean, it just felt so beautiful. So, it was the most perfect day.
And who could have planned this when we booked the venue, 2 years ago?
Yeah, 2 years out. You just pick a day.
I know.
You have no idea what the weather's going to be like.
Could have been a hurricane for all we knew.
Yeah. Oh, I know. The whole month leading up to the day was scorching hot, and then it was raining,
yep,
even just like 24 hours before.
Right.
And it just cleared. So you guys got your wedding video back on Christmas Eve.
Yes, that's right.
So I took a couple of snippets, whatever.
Wow, you only had a couple sips? What happened?
Yeah, no, I'm already losing it. I posted on SmorgShow.com, if you don't mind.
Oh, yeah, not at all.
There
you
go. I put your little short video
I
there.
I see that.
Yeah, look at that.
And the daddy-daughter dance, and then I did my the best man speech. Best man, father of the bride speech, sorry. I forgot, I got promoted.
Wow, you think highly of yourself.
Yeah.
We waited about 3 months for our video, and it felt like a long wait, but oh my gosh, as soon as we got the video back, we got like the 7-minute teaser trailer, kind of the highlight reel of the day, and then the full edit, which was an hour and 40 minutes of just documenting the whole day. And like, we were speechless. Like, we could not be pleased with it. They did a phenomenal job. So
do you want to call them out there if anybody's looking for a videographer? Videographer.
Yes. Travis from Bella Tiamo. They did a phenomenal job. How we met them was at a wedding expo at the Whitetail Ridge Golf Club. I would say that was actually January of 2020 before anything was going on. The world was still, it felt perfectly normal. In fact, actually, February 14th, that was Valentine's Day of 2021, we went to the Chicago Auto Show. Mm-hmm. And again, completely normal. Nothing felt like...
That was our last big gathering.
It really was. Yeah. I would say that was the last time that Chicago felt normal to anybody.
Right. Well, interesting thing about the vendor event that we went to that January was when we were at the vendor event, we had gotten the news, the headline come through that about the Kobe Bryant helicopter accident.
Oh my gosh.
So that was actually, I remember that was the first like newsworthy thing of 2020 that kind of just set the stage for the rest of the year. It's like, whoa, that's like, what a weird way to start the year off.
Yeah.
And who would have thought that that wasn't the biggest event of that year?
Right. That kind of got swept underneath all the other hot garbage of the year.
Goodness. You're telling me.
Anything else from this past year that you particularly, I mean, that's big. I mean, how do you top your wedding?
Yeah, get married, yeah.
Yeah,
well, I have my first full-blooded cousin was born this year. So I have half cousins, I have step cousins, but in terms of like, it's my mom's brother and his wife had a baby this year. And so that was really cool. So he and I are the bookends of March. My birthday's March 1st. He's March 31st. So it'll always be easy to remember his birthday.
Yeah, yeah, that's very true.
What about you?
Yeah,
what happened
about me? I got promoted at yes. my job. I work at Menards, so I'm the now the second no first assistant manager of the cabinets and appliances department.
Designing kitchens for people.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You like that kind of work?
I do. It's something I knew nothing about the year prior, and it started when COVID hit. They were like, hey, Thomas, we want you to move over to this other department. And it started out being a temporary thing, and then I sort of grew into it, and they're like, okay, well, we think you want to stay here. And you do a good job at it. And then I think it was how it happened this year was my manager who did vacate the position. Basically, because that position was available, the general managers approached me and was like, hey, Thomas, I think that you should do this too. And you're already a good designer, and I think this is just the next step for you. So I figured, well, I'm here, might as well make a little more money, right?
Yeah.
Well, you're already there.
Yes.
Might as well.
So I would say one of our big accomplishments of this year was we really knocked out our end year goal for our actual Menards brand of cabinets, Clearview Cabinetry.
Wow, what a plug on the podcast.
Yeah. Clearview Cabinetry is a fantastic cabinet system. It's super versatile. And we really decided to ramp it up this year. Our goal was $180,000 in Clearview sales for the year. And we will now end out 2021 with $280,000.
Wow.
Nice job.
SmorgShow approves this message.
Yeah, right. Yeah, well, you know your stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was exciting. And then his parents moved to Florida at the start of November. So
big
the
changes.
Holidays just looked different this year.
Yeah, we had to share you guys this year.
That's
right. So it's a little different for us, too.
Yeah, so we stayed local for Thanksgiving. And then for Christmas, we flew down to, they live on the Gulf side. And so we flew down there for a few days, spent Christmas there. It was weird spending Christmas on the beach.
On the beach,
first time.
But it was beautiful, and we had a great time. And then came back. We got back night of the 26th, and then we're celebrating we've celebrated three Christmases
I
this
know.
Year.
Oh yeah,
four, or four Christmases, just
and
like
it
the
was,
movie.
It was such a stark contrast to coming home from the beautiful, just sunny beaches and the white sand and clear water and just wearing shorts and flip flops and whatnot, and then coming back and the next day having a nice old snowstorm.
Yeah.
But because we were still extending Christmas, I'm okay with the snow.
Right.
But when the
right.
new year comes, I want it to be gone.
I'm done, yeah.
And we're going to be hit with more January and February. But, and probably until, May?
Goodness.
Yeah, right.
At this rate? I mean, remember, we had that little flurry, I think it was in either November or maybe October or something.
Yeah, we did have a little teaser flurry.
That's
yeah.
right. It didn't stick, though, so
no.
I didn't
no.
count
Thank
in my
goodness.
Books.
Right.
Yeah.
Winter
yeah,
lights.
To go from white sand to white snow.
Exactly.
So what about you, Dad? How was this year big for you?
Yeah, Dad.
Well, obviously, leading up to your wedding was very emotional for me. And it sort of marked my last official obligation to you.
I guess I'll show up.
No, not to showing up. I mean, from a financial standpoint.
Oh, got it.
You know, it's like you raise you go off to college, and then you get married. It's like now next stop is retirement. I hate to say it. My next milestone is retirement, which actually isn't too far away.
But that's an exciting milestone.
Yeah.
You know?
No.
What do you think you'll take up golf when you do you think you'll fit into that stereotype?
No.
Of all sports though, I feel like
that was
what would your sport be?
If I had to do a sport, I think it would be golf.
See,
even though I've never golfed other than
mini golf.
I'm still calling it basketball.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he's had such good luck with basketball in the
promising
past.
Promising basketball career.
Oh, you're talking about me?
Yes.
Oh, you heard about my stories.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, my broken finger.
Legends.
Yeah, oh yeah. No, that's not a good sight.
Well, then as a kid, scoring for the other team,
getting
booed.
I forgot about that. You're bringing back you're ripping
all
a
your trauma.
That's right. I scored for the only time I ever got a basket in gym class was for the other team, which of course, then I got the crap beaten out of me in the locker room.
Oh, goodness.
Dude, it's gym class. Calm down. There's always that one kid.
Well, I think at least at this point, then it's finally time to redeem yourself.
Yeah, you think so?
I don't know. I think you have a chance.
So.
No? Okay.
Nah.
We'll see what the future holds.
I think it might be golf.
Yeah.
Yeah, other than that, I mean, the passing of my stepdad, in October or November, it was a sort of a detour on how the year was going.
Yeah, definitely.
So the holidays were a little bit different and more difficult because Christmas Eve I had to, I spent the night with my mom, and she wasn't in the mood to celebrate really. So it was just more of a comforting evening.
Yeah.
So it was
so grateful that he was at the wedding though, that we got to share that last moment with him. So
that was the last time I saw him. Yeah. He was at the wedding.
Yeah. He was stuck in Canada for 14 months because the border was shut down, and we're just so blessed that he was able to get back here for
like a couple months before the wedding and was here just in time. Yeah. And then our kind of guest book thing that we did for the wedding was it was this slab of, well, maybe you can talk about it since you designed it.
Or sure.
Carpentry. What's the verb? Carpentried? Whatever it is.
Carpentered.
There you go.
Right.
So what I did was I actually, sorry about that. I had this slab of, I believe it was a wild maple, that I had in my my basement for probably over a year because I used part of it, Allie, for your cutting board or charcuterie
serving
board.
Yeah.
So I milled it down. I bought it from a local guy who was chopping down trees. And I had this piece drying out, and I figured, hey, this is a wide enough board. I'd like to do something with it and maybe incorporate it into our wedding. And it turned out that the best use for that was our guest book.
Yeah.
So it was still a rough piece of wood that I spent, I would say, a good amount of hours sort of carving down to a...
And sanding down.
Yes.
It was
yes.
Really smooth.
Planing, sanding to a manageable slab. And then Allie was super kind enough to help me. We stenciled the our name, Larson, as well as the wedding date on
the wood.
On the wood itself, yes. That was a pretty funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the reason for me bringing that up was that my grandfather that passed. It's like I'm so glad that we got his signature on there, and he wrote a little message to us and. So, yeah, we'll always have that.
And he actually signed it with a different color pen than everybody else.
Yeah,
so really
we at first
out.
Were like, oh, my gosh, he used a different colored pen. Like, oh, it's going to stick up. But now it's cute that it sticks out.
Yeah,
definitely.
So, just in closing here, I want to actually not close it. We're going to transition to another segment here. We're going to move into a different lounge. But just a closing, just to introduce, we're talking about Thomas, my son-in-law. He has actually been on the show twice before. Once. You played a part in our radio play, Rope.
Yes, you were Brandon.
Brandon.
Yeah, you're right.
The conniving Brandon.
That's right. And you guys came down together for our 100th episode, and you played a couple songs for us here.
Oh, that's right. I remember that.
At the very end of the show, yeah.
Yeah.
I forget what we
live
sang.
In the barn, actually. We were it was at the barn.
It's pretty chilly then.
You sang your original. Yeah, you sang your original.
I don't know which one that was.
The Down by the River or whatever it's called.
Come to the River.
Come to the River.
Yeah.
And the Echo Smith.
Or to the River. That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Time flies.
Yeah. All right. We're going to transition into the next segment. We'll be back in just a second. Don't go away.
You're listening to the Smorg Show Podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, a different kind of lounge. Okay.
Yeah.
You're starting to feel so mellowed out with the last one.
Liven it up a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
This sounds like New Year's Eve kind of music.
This is a collage or sort of a mix from 2021 music. And we're just going to keep this in the background because what we're going to do now is we're going to do a pop quiz. 20 questions.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
There's no pressure. You guys can work together on it. You can answer together. I'm not keeping points. I just want to see... I took a bunch of questions from all different topics. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Do you know any of these artists?
Hey, this is Doja Cat.
There you go.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Wow, good for you.
So you're going to be good
See,
at
you're
this.
You're going to do well, I can already tell.
So I got questions from top news, top entertainment news, top woke news. I mean, I got it all here.
Ooh.
All right. Well, I don't think our head was too buried under the sand this year. So. Okay.
All right, so we're just going to go through this real quick. See how well you were paying attention to 2021. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Wow, nice transition there.
Nice. Okay, number one. In his first address to Congress as a president, President Joe Biden said some words that no president has ever said. Which were they? A, when I was vice president. B, Madam House Speaker. C, Madam Vice President. D, gun violence has been an epidemic.
Huh, what do you think?
Well, I know there were some things that were said, but they had been said before by past administrations.
Right, because like this isn't the first time a vice president
has run
for president.
However, it is the first time that a female vice president has been in the position.
Oh, wait a second.
Yep, I know where you're going.
Oh, I see what you're saying, Matt. Oh, yeah, of course.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, so, you know what? I don't know why my brain, I was thinking when you said Madam Vice President, I was thinking you said Madam First Lady, and I was like, oh, yeah, there's been lots of First Ladies.
Right.
But yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yep.
So,
okay.
So you got this one.
C, Madam Vice President. Ding, ding, ding. Okay, good.
Yes.
Number two, who was the first person in history to take off in his own spaceship? A, Elon Musk. B, Jeff Bezos. C, Richard Branson. D, Alan Shepard.
I have to go with B, Jeff Bezos.
Oh, goodness. You know, that's a toss-up. I thought it was... No, it is... You're right. It was Jeff Bezos.
Yeah, because then all of the Amazon workers finally got to take a bathroom break.
The answer is actually C, Richard Branson.
Wait, that's right.
That's the first... Oh, okay.
From Virgin.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh,
yes.
Yeah.
But Jeff Bezos, I mean, that was this year.
Right. It was.
All right.
Okay, that's okay.
I guess I jumped the... I was too confident about that one.
That's what I was going to say also, but... Okay, C, number three. What was the United States' longest war? A, Vietnam War. B, Afghanistan. C, Gulf. D, Civil.
I believe, as of now, it is the Afghanistan War.
Yes. Ding, ding, ding.
Mm-hmm.
Number four. What was the message printed on Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez's dress at the 2021 Met Gala? A, equal rights for women. B, in gay we trust. C, peg the patriarchy. D, tax the rich.
D, tax the rich.
That's right.
Right. Okay. Number five.
At an event for rich people.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Where everyone else was supposed to be masked, however, the guests were not.
And the servers were masked.
That's right.
Yeah. Number five. How was Mr. Potato Head different from today when it was launched in 1952? A, it wasn't called Mr. Potato Head. B, shoppers had to supply their own real potato. C, it was wooden. Or D, it was a comic strip.
I think it's just Potato Head now, right?
That's right.
Yeah. So no Mr. They dropped the Mr. this year.
Well, that is true.
Or is this a trick question?
It might be a trick question because the question said, how is Mr. Potato Head different from today?
Oh, from today. Oh, I see what you're saying. Well, yeah, it was Mr. Wait, read option A again.
Yeah, it wasn't called Mr. Potato Head, meaning back then.
Oh, so, I see.
No. B, shoppers had to supply their own real potato.
Oh, okay.
And actually, I was just watching, you know that on the History Channel, they've got those series, you know, The Foods That Built America. There's one that's called The Toys That Built America. And I was watching an episode on Mr. Potato Head. And they showed these guys just basically selling the parts. But you had to supply the potato. Yeah, which was a big challenge because people had just come out of the Great Depression.
Oh,
they weren't into wasting food.
Understandable.
So it was a little challenge to launch that product. Yeah.
Well, you know, you make a friend and then, you know, when he starts to look a little mushy, then you make mashed potatoes. So
yeah.
It doesn't go to waste.
That's right.
Okay, number six. In 2021, Facebook changed Instagram's nudity policy.
I'm not aware of the...
Who knew?
Right.
What changed? A, to clarify that baby nudes are allowed. B...
Would not be surprised.
Yeah. To clarify that health-related nudity is allowed. C, to clarify that educational-related nudity is allowed. And D, to clarify that non-sexual naturist nudity is allowed.
Oh.
So...
Huh.
That's a tough one.
Yeah, baby nudes, health-related, educational.
I really hope it's not A.
Yeah, really.
No. I would say it's either probably the educational aspect or it is the, with the naturist.
Naturist, because that would be excluding a community if you don't allow their family photos on there.
It's actually health-related.
Oh.
Health-related. So what would that, I feel like, I mean, couldn't you be, don't get mad at me, it was health-related.
I have a chest cold. See?
Right, yeah, right.
What's health right. related?
I hey, guess... Do these hemorrhoids look bad to you?
I what mean... is it called? Blue waffles?
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, I don't know about that one.
Well, health related. I mean, yeah, I mean, I guess if, I don't know. I don't know what hashtag you would look up to.
Yeah, I know. Okay, number seven.
All right, it's interesting.
Yeah, number seven. What was Greta Thunberg's first public act of environmentalist activism? Her first public act. A, sailing across the Atlantic Ocean from England to New York. B, attending the UN Climate Action Summit in New York City. C, protesting at the World Economic Forum held in Davos, Switzerland. D, skipping school to protest outside the Swedish Parliament.
You know, I am pretty sure that it actually was, I thought it was A, sailing to New York because she didn't want to fly. But I thought it wasted more fuel than flying or something.
How dare you?
Well, actually, to get technical, this wasn't 2021, was it?
That is,
this is a maybe 2019 question, I think.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
You're busy DJing over there.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm trying to turn this down.
I think you're right. I think it was the sailing. But then I also am inclined to say the skipping school thing, because that probably was like the first.
Yeah.
The first thing. I don't know.
How dare you? Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah.
The answer is actually...
Blah, blah, blah. Oh, blah, blah,
I can't
blah.
Stop this.
I haven't heard that voice in so long.
Skipping school to protest outside the Swedish Parliament.
I was thinking that's probably the first, you know.
Yeah. Okay,
you don't
small
just,
steps.
You don't all of a sudden sit,
sure.
get on a
sailboat.
You got to start off small.
Right, skipping right. school definitely. Is a big, yeah.
And then the Davos group, wow.
Yeah, I guess Davos. I should have said Davos. I don't know why I said Davos. Okay, eight. What is the U.S. state where Juneteenth originated? A, Texas. B, Florida. C, California. D, Tennessee. Where Juneteenth originated.
Wait, read the options again.
Texas, Florida, California.
Blah, 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 blah.
I can't stop her.
It's got to be California.
I would actually say Texas.
It was Texas.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah.
That one got me tripping.
That was a tricky one. Okay, number nine. What is colorism?
Huh.
Is it different than racism?
Well, we'll find out. A, prejudice against individuals with darker skin among people of the same ethnic group.
That sounds right, actually.
B, a postmodern art movement. C, the art of colorizing old films. And D, a transparent optical element with a flat, polished surface.
It does sound like the art movement because of cubism. You know, I think it was like play on cubism with Picasso. No, I think it's the first one where they colorism.
Yep, you're right. Ding, ding, ding.
Because right. if woke news is in here, I don't think you would stick an art culture, trivia question in there.
Yeah, no, that was a woke question. Number 10, according to billionaire Jeff Bezos, who paid for his space adventure? A, every American employee, every Amazon employee and every Amazon customer.
Probably.
I think that's it.
Okay. What are the other options, though? Sorry, I'm jumping
B, he said he did it on his own.
Yeah,
C, the American taxpayer. every citizen on Earth.
Oh, okay. Well, those wouldn't be I didn't let you finish.
If you think indirectly, every citizen who has...
Yeah, anyone who's ordered from Amazon, you're contributing to his space venture.
So, you're welcome, Jeff.
Yeah, I guess so.
What is the answer? Is it A?
Yeah, it was A.
Oh, of course.
Yeah. Let's just say I'm very glad that on that day... the Amazon employees were able to finally use a bathroom.
Yes,
those greedy employees.
Take a 15-minute break, lunch break.
Uh-huh. All right, we're half done here.
Okay.
Number 11. Right. In her music video, Your Power, Billie Eilish appears with an animal. What is it?
Oh, gosh. I couldn't care less.
A serpent, a terrapin, a squamate reptile, a panthera leo.
Since the only one I can pronounce is serpent. And that makes sense to me, I would choose A.
You're right. Sorry, another Billie Eilish question. When winning the Record of the Year award in the 2021 Grammys, Billie Eilish said, "Someone else deserves that honor." Who was it? Phineas, Beyonce, Taylor Swift, Megan Thee Stallion.
I would... say maybe she was being biased and saying Phineas, her older brother.
He is the producer and he's kind of the genius behind a lot of her music.
That's true. However, I'm sorry, it was Beyonce,
Taylor Swift,
and Megan Thee Stallion.
Megan Thee Stallion.
It might be that one.
Oh gosh. Yeah, I don't know. I would either say Phineas or maybe even Beyonce. I don't know. But she didn't read.
Well, if she said, Megan Thee Stallion, didn't she kind of come out of nowhere in the last couple years? And so maybe she's wanting her to be recognized. I don't know. And Beyonce's already won so many things. So is Taylor Swift. I doubt that she would call out someone who's already. Yeah.
No, you're right, Allie.
Is it Megan Thee Stallion?
Yeah, Megan Thee Stallion.
But Phineas also makes sense because
he
doesn't get a lot of credit, but I think he actually likes being in the background.
Yeah.
I mean, he's kind of got it made. You don't have any of the press bothering you.
That's right.
To a certain extent.
Yeah.
Definitely. Well, I think the first time and probably the only time I've heard something featuring Megan Thee Stallion, if I'm correct, is WAP.
Yeah, that's all I know her from.
So yeah,
deserving of an honor after that.
Right.
Just like, I don't know if you guys are familiar with Saweetie, but the only time I actually had ever heard of Saweetie was from the Saweetie meal that McDonald's was advertising for quite some time.
Wow.
when they went through a phase where they were basing their meals on celebrities or groups, and I was like, okay, is this something exclusive with McDonald's? And I didn't know the name.
They've had a few of those. They had like a BTS meal and just recently a Mariah Carey meal.
Oh, did they really?
Yeah, they did for Christmas.
I remember they had the Travis Scott meal.
Oh, that too. Yeah.
What's his name? The food guy on YouTube that you showed me. What's his name?
Oh, Matt Stoney?
No, the guy that does the thing he used to do it from his car. He reviews the fast food.
Oh, the Report of the Week.
Report of the
guy.
Week.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whatever his name is. He just did
Review
the,
Bra.
Yeah.
Review Bra. He just did a review of the
Mariah Carey. How I heard about it. So I hear I hear about all the updated McDonald's meals from him.
So, well, I guess the follow-up question is, what made the Mariah Carey meal different or special?
I didn't actually see that one. I just saw the headline that he had done that.
Yeah, I don't know what it was. But I know a lot of them, it's just as simple as like, we brought back a sauce or something.
A different sauce, Now, who was the Mariah? Which is the restaurant that did the Mariah?
Oh, Carey? McDonald's.
McDonald's did that? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I think it was Pizza Hut did something recently that did a
this
celebrity.
Whole podcast has been sponsored by First Clearview, McDonald's, and Pizza Hut.
That's right.
Yeah, we're trying to take it up a notch here and get some sponsors.
Right,
All right, let's go here. Number 13, what is blackfishing? A, illegal whale fishing. B, luring somebody with a fictional online persona. C, pretending to be of darker skin on social media. And D, making exaggerated claims about emotional problems to get sympathy. Blackfishing.
It is C, pretending to be of a different skin color on social media. And I know this because Ariana Grande was accused of it. Because,
why would you do that?
Well, I mean, here's the thing. They call people out on it, whether they do it intentionally or not. But for a while, a lot of Ariana Grande's like photos, she must have been getting a lot of spray tans or something where she was just looking a lot darker skinned in her photos, and people almost to the point of, wow, she looks like a different ethnicity now. But then people were accusing her of like Asian fishing, where now in some of her photos, her skin is like, is a lot lighter, and the way that she dresses. And then now some of her photos, it's like, oh my gosh, now Ariana Grande looks Asian. So there's all kinds of, I think it's a play on word with the catfishing, which is, I think, option B that you said, where you're luring someone with a false picture or whatever. Yeah. So it's kind of like that, but just the race aspect with it.
Got it. That would fall under the woke category, I guess.
I guess I'm pretty woke then.
Yeah. All right. Number 14. What pop star was freed of her conservatorship?
Oh, we know this.
Rihanna, Christina Aguilera, Britney Spears, Katy Perry.
Free Britney!
Let Britney go.
Leave Britney alone.
Right. That's what I was thinking of.
So two follow-up questions to that one. What does the word conservator mean? A, political right-wing tendency. B, I like this one. Okay. B, a broker of cultural artifacts. C, a professional preserving animal bodies. What?
Well, it's not that one.
And D, a legal guardian or trustee.
It is D, a legal guardian trustee.
Yeah, and so with Brittany, it was her dad had possession of,
I think it was actually, was it since her 2008 breakout? Or when she kind of like went off the rails?
2007,
okay. When she shaved her head?
Yeah,
because now in hindsight, everyone's looking back on that and thinking that, oh my gosh, we all thought Brittany was going crazy and all this stuff, but it was...
Cry for help,
just the situation she was in, and I don't know the extent of everything that happened, but I don't know if there was abuse or any, or at least with, I don't know, some sort of manipulation. So it's more of a cry for help than...
Unless that was the catalyst to her being put under a conservatorship.
And then since then, they haven't released their grip from her.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
That's a good point, too. I don't know the whole, all the details of the case, because I don't know how long it's been going on, because she's been a star for so long. Hey, I like this song.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Post Malone, Circles.
Yeah, I got it all here.
Are you going to be copyrighted for all this music?
Oh, good point. I will be flagged.
Remember,
in multiple
that was
countries.
That was what fueled Artists of the Week segments, where we would feature upcoming artists.
That's a good point. I think we're going to be censored.
We may be overdubbing with royalty free music. We'll see when you hear it. We'll find out if it was circles or I don't know.
Yeah. Well, if we keep talking,
Shack
we can
the
just
country.
We
I
can
know.
Just call it a remix because we're adding our own vocals. In,
I should have brought it down like a pitch a little bit. So it doesn't recognize it.
That would have been
good. I hate
that.
Trying to watch those movies on YouTube.
And they're sped up or something.
Wee, wee, wee.
Yeah, right. Just, right.
Number 16, according to Britney Spears, June 23rd, 2021, conservatorship court testimony. Which of these is true? A, the conservatorship has control over her reproductive health. B, she was forced to take medications that she did not want. C, she was forced to perform against her will. D, all of the above.
Oh, well. I don't know. Do you know?
I thought it was, I think C, definitely.
Yeah, but it could have been all of them.
It could have been. Yeah. I don't know. Let's go
either
crazy.
C or D.
Let's say.
Yeah, it's all
D.
of the above. Sad.
Wow. That's, see, this is more than I knew. I didn't know all the details.
That's insane. I wonder what that falls under.
Wow.
But, you know, I mean, there's a reason why a bunch of child stars act out, or you hear about them just getting in trouble years later, is because, like, you know, they I don't know, just being put into that industry at such a young age, and then it kind of stunts their development, and they never quite mature past the age of how old they were when they got famous.
That's why I admire Butch Patrick. You don't hear anything about Eddie Munster. Eddie Munster.
Oh, Eddie Munster.
He stayed out of trouble. Yeah, he's still alive.
Oh, okay.
That's good. He's managed to stay out of trouble.
But you know, I find it's like you can count on one hand how many Disney stars have gotten out alive or gotten out clear conscience or been just okay on the other side. You just find so many of these cases.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Disney's bad news.
These poor kids have been subjected to, you know, so many questionable, if not awful, things, and then they later in life they're having trouble just coping with it and dealing with it, and either blocking it out by acting out or something more nefarious or deadly.
Well, it's not just Disney too; it's Nickelodeon.
Oh,
and,
sure.
Like,
oh,
yeah. And even if a lot of stuff in years later, like I would say this year was a year for a lot of things being exposed.
That's a good. That's a very good point.
And and actually, so there's actually a guy on YouTube that we've watched a lot of his videos. His name is Sloan, and he spells it S-L, the number zero, the number four, N-E, where it looks like Sloan.
Yeah, look at an A.
I don't think there's an E. Is there an E?
There's an E.
No, there's not an
E. Or
E.
Is it a three?
No, there is nothing after N.
I don't know. I don't know. But either way, you can find him, and he did a lot of videos exposing stuff about the thing with Britney, and then also just with all of these Nickelodeon and Disney stars and just things that had been uncovered and kind of exposed in that industry, and how many like creepy producers there are that go on to still produce on other sets even after being convicted of things.
That's
it's
right.
It's disgusting.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Well, think of, I think something that was in some news outlets but wasn't covered all that much was this whole debacle with Drake Bell and allegedly assaulting a minor at the time. And then I think that...
Yeah, whatever happened with that?
Well, I mean, it's a slap in the wrist as usual. But
sure.
I remember that Sloan was actually keeping up pretty up to date as far as what the trial was doing.
And he was keeping...
And then it got to a point where Drake Bell had called him out and had gotten his personal number and was communicating with him. It was like some weird thing where he was like trying to get in touch with him and trying to meet up, but it was it kind of sounded just very intimidating. And I think Drake may have been trying to silence Sloan because of the stuff that he was just saying about Drake, which I think was totally warranted on Sloan's part. But it kind of just sounds like
which is why it's Josh Peck being featured on a new episode of iCarly.
Instead
of
Oh, he's on there.
There are pictures of like, oh, they're back together. Our favorite duo is back, and it's like, oh, okay, we're ignoring the.
Notice a lack of Jeanette McCurdy too on iCarly.
Oh well, she actually walked away from the industry for also experiencing a lot of trauma. And not even just trauma on set from producers, but from her own parents that kind of, I mean, a lot of these kids, their parents force them into the industry and then, you know, for whatever reason, for financial reasons, whatever. And so she, I think, was manipulated or abused by family and then also producers. So.
Okay. Oh, who? Dan Schneider?
Probably. So sorry, that was a really sorry if we got heavy. We're pulling a Jerry. We're pulling a Jerry.
Yeah, I know. I'm feeling ambushed here. 2-on-1 here. At least I can control Jerry.
Sorry.
Okay, let's finish this up here. Last segment. We got the last few questions here. This is under the social media category. Number 17. What is Twitter blue? A, social media related depression. B, Jack Dorsey's Twitter handle. C, the company's account verification service, and D, the company's subscription service.
I think it's actually the subscription service.
Right. I had not heard of that.
I'm feeling Twitter blue. Not the depression.
I have been off Twitter for a year now.
That's it's good. It's beautiful. Toxic.
It's toxic.
It's mentally...
It's a wasteland of depression. Of just angry
people. It's an echo chamber of angry people. Yeah.
Yeah.
Shout out to Telegram.
Yeah. Number 18, who are the Disinformation Dozen? Did you ever hear of them? I never heard.
Disinformation Dozen?
A, 12 people responsible for most of the anti-vaccine content on social media. B, 12 governments responsible for most of the fake content on social media. C, 12 organizations responsible for the most of the hate speech on social media. And D, 12 social media platforms responsible for most of the information on the internet.
I've never heard of this before.
I have not either.
Well, you wonder what angle they're going for, because unfortunately we live in a world where disinformation, depending on which side you're on, means something completely different.
Yeah.
So my gut is to go towards the 12 people who were talking about talking against the vaccine.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, all right. That's
ding,
what I figured.
Ding, yep.
But the interesting thing is that if you want to take this a step further and look at it from a different angle, that there are, what, six corporations that control everything, that own everything.
Something yeah. like that, yeah.
So really, the information you're like getting, the information you're getting, and then you know when you see the exact same headline or the exact same script from news anchors, like yeah. it all comes from those six corporations that's how you get your information.
And it's so always top down echo chambers.
Right.
Yeah. All it takes is one, you know, Zoom meeting and then everybody sends out like the I don't know.
Yeah. The talking points for the day.
Yeah. Right.
No, you got that right. Number 19. What is the meaning of the word metaverse? A, the concept of parallel universes. B, an analogy. C, multiple fictional stories that occur in the same environment. D, virtual meeting spaces.
It would be D, virtual meeting spaces. Brought to you by formerly Facebook, but now the company Meta. And Meta. Mark, sweet baby Ray.
Zuckerberg.
Which, speaking of Zuckerberg, am I allowed to read what's on this shocking post-it note sitting in front of me?
Oh, that's coming up on a... hold that thought.
Oh, okay. I don't want to spoil an upcoming...
Well, yeah, I'm gonna talk about that in just a second here as we close out the show. Okay, the last question.
All right.
Excuse me.
D?
On which social platform can one tap the I prayed button? A, MyHeritage. B, Parler. C, Facebook. D, TikTok.
I'm going to say probably Parler.
Yeah. Is it Parler?
Actually, it's Facebook, surprisingly. It's got the little
what?
Pray.
What? That's new. I prayed?
Really?
That's new. Oh, hey! Oh. You're tugging my headphones.
Oh, sorry.
I'm unplugged.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. Hold on a second. Is that right?
Or is it, you know, when sometimes you go to make a comment on Facebook and then they have those auto replies all set for you where it says, oh, congrats or whatever. Is it one of those?
Good question.
I'm looking right now.
It's definitely not one of the like the default emojis or like the care or the surprise or wow, angry.
Right. Yeah. It's not that.
Like.
Try to leave a comment on
why
something.
Why? That can't be a right answer then.
It must be. Here, let me go to my phone real quick.
Unless it is an auto suggest, which it could be.
There's no pray button.
Bring the pray button,
I was
Facebook.
Thinking of the pray
come on.
I was thinking of the pray emoji, but you're right.
Maybe it's P-R-E-Y as in pray
on
others.
On minors.
Yeah, right?
Oh, gosh. Oh. Well, I just know
Facebook
that if...
So, be like,
let's say that somebody is posts something about their birthday on Facebook, and then if you go to comment on it, sometimes there's like this little auto pop-up bubbles where it's like just a quick happy birthday or a suggested emoji, and
maybe.
I wonder if there's one like that where it's like I prayed if someone's like oh I'm asking for prayer requests about something.
You know what's funny is actually yesterday I was wishing somebody a happy birthday on Facebook because I wouldn't obviously do it in real life, gosh, weird. But one of the suggestions, I think it was either from Facebook or from Apple, was Happy Thanksgiving. And I almost typed it.
Oh, sorry.
Oh. What was that?
This is not a phone holder.
Oh. No, it isn't.
Sorry.
And I had to catch myself. Otherwise, it would have been a very confused message to someone I don't know all that well.
All right, this music's giving me a headache. Oh. All right, back to the lounge here. Okay. So... Well, good job, guys. I think you got most of those right.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think
probably
we got
18
at least
out of
20. An A minus or
yeah.
B plus.
I think you know your culture.
Unfortunately.
So yeah, just to mention what Allie was saying, I want to say that this is a big news here. This is going to be, I think, at least as of right now, the last long form podcast that we do.
Did you purposely pause after last to keep people like, oh, this is the last
episode? This is the last one. No, I couldn't think of the words I was thinking of. I couldn't think of long form. I was struggling.
In this format.
In this format, where we just kind of ramble for sometimes up to an hour and a half. We realize that people kind of bail out after maybe 15 minutes because, you know, it's like, it's the old radio show where people hang in for the entire, you know, duration of the show. That's kind of an old thing. People are busy. So coming in January, what I envision is that we're going to have like a quick, just nail it, 15 minutes tops. One topic, one segment, in, out, that's it. And what I think that will allow us to do is to put more episodes out more frequently So like when I have Dave and Jerry out here for the studio, it's like a big event because, you know, these guys have to travel and we do like two episodes together for like an hour and we put them out and then we go away for like 3 months. Well, if they come out here, we can probably crank out maybe 20 episodes.
Yeah, that's right. And then just kind of have them up your sleeve and release just, them when you want.
Yeah, just time release them over every things. Week. Exactly.
But then people can, you know, pick and choose what they want to listen to. If they're really interested in one particular topic, then they can find it instead of scrolling through a two-hour episode. And
what this means is a couple of things. Well, the big thing is that Baba will no longer be on the podcast.
No!
I know! He has his own podcast.
Okay, good.
Which will continue.
Which is what? Number? Is it still number one in the Indian folklore category?
Yes! He is number one in Africa and Saudi Arabia, but not India.
But I thought the category in like iTunes or the podcasts?
Hinduism.
Whatever. Oh, okay, number one.
He was number one in Hinduism for the first, I guess, 8 weeks of his launch. But he's still somewhere in the top 10, which is amazing.
But he probably fell off the number one. He probably got a lot of clicks in the beginning, and then people realized what it really was. And then just,
well, I think he just needs to keep climbing those charts.
Yeah, right.
Like, just keep stepping it up.
Well, he gets consistent downloads. It's amazing.
It's a movement.
Yeah. So for the time being, I think Baba will continue to be on his own show. But it'll just be me, Jerry, Dave, you guys, whenever you're out here, whatever we feel like doing. So look for more episodes in that format coming in January. So back to what you found there on the Post-it. I was just scribbling down some topics for our first couple of episodes. And what do they say?
Well, I was going to read out loud, Zuckerberg wants your nudes, but that will be for another time.
I was just brainstorming. Yes, that's shocking to hear that. But yes, he's looking for you to upload those. And then what's the other one?
Notre Dame Woke Museum.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Or, I'm sorry, Notre Dame.
Yeah, however you say it. They are rebuilding that after it burned down. And yeah, so that'll be coming in January and many, many more. So there you got something to look forward to in 2022.
Can't wait.
Woohoo!
What an exciting new year.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, happy new year, everybody.
Well, that's it.
On that note.
All right, thank you, Allie and Thomas, for coming out to the studio. I had a great time with you.
Thanks for having us.
Happy New Year to everybody.
Happy New Year. Good luck on all those resolutions in the first week.
I go to the gym more than once this year. Come on, guys. You can do it.
I got to come up with something. This is the Smorg Show Podcast. Find us at smorgshow.com, 312-95-SMORG. And you know where to find us on social media. Just look for Smorg Show. Have a good New Year's.
Blah, 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 blah.